guys, you're Rick DeBears, and welcome back to my 15-16 lip poker, and where we last time left off, I was frustrated beyond belief. Like, if you did not see the last episode, I was close to breaking something. That's how angry last episode made me. So, but I'm not gonna let it get to me. Not gonna let it get to me. I'll see. In summer, in the summer window, I'll just have to address the problems. Because obviously, there's clearly something wrong. What it is, I don't know yet, but I will figure it out. You can count on it.
The FA Cup. Don't really need to say.
In the meantime, I have an FA Cup game against Ipswich, so let's get into that. Let's focus on that.
Liverpool.
Go with this team today. But the referee's got to manage this match, and giving the foul, I think, is quite a good thing to do.
Ojo, who is just back from a loan at Ipswich, he returned at the end of the last episode.
The opposition could get at them.
In time to play against them, weirdly enough.
He could be the star turn for Liverpool today.
Well, he's one of the best finishers around, without question. You look at his goal ratio down the years, and impressive to say the least.
That. Ricky, I was kind of hoping you would control better, you know? Ojo. Emmanuel will steps in to make sure I don't get the cross. Yeah. But he did concede a corner. Which is come to pull it.
Challenge, he made the block.
And show. Corner.
That bit lucky, it was deflected. A decent fist away by the keeper.
Get back in. It's Ojo!
That is a terrific.
Tar is over.
They generated some power on it, and the keeper wasn't getting there.
To keep the opposition pen back, this throw can help do that.
Ojo.
That will help ease the pressure.
Pass is off.
A little penalized.
That was a good challenge. I win the ball.
And he's read the situation perfectly with that interception.
He's got his shot off now.
A good hit at it, but
it's okay, they're shot miles wide. Orban. Pull it. Ojo. Which is way in. Ah! Oh, I thought the keeper was gonna stumble over the line with the ball. Sanchez.
Attacking now.
Penalty.
Tackled well. It's a good challenge. It's led to a corner.
And here's the shot. Ojo. Great save. It's gonna come back to him. Come on, fall. Briggy, he can't hit it before he's tackled. God damn it. and Parr clears it. It's straight back. Origi! What a pass! What a goal! Oh. That is exactly the response I wanted to see.
And what a finish this was. Really did put his boot through it to find the left-hand side.
Different angle on it here.
A superb finish after a brilliant pass. That is how you score for a good goal. Ozo. I am
quite good for Liverpool. But only quite good. They would have hoped to be in a stronger position, but it could be worse, of course, as we look towards the clock and half-time approaching.
Here's the cross.
That's a bit cynical, really. You can understand why they were in trouble. Free kick.
Hey, Nacho. Go, Sanchez. Go. Go. Ah! Cross isn't the best. This goal kick may be the last thing of the first half. It's not.
See it.
My keeper's gonna get that. He waited! Freaking idiot!
Well, the referee has signaled for half time, and it's 1-0 here.
I don't know what took him so long to gather it. He kind of slowed down.
The second half starts now.
Yeah, well, the first half didn't disappoint.
I don't know anymore. Seems like my players are getting dumber and dumber every time I play. Bojo. Turbe. Mrs. Origi! That's gonna be a next switch throw.
Touré. And they're still going backwards all the way to the goalkeeper. Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well. He's certainly been an influence on this.
Yeah, to see his goal.
Put his team ahead, he'll be pleased with that first.
What a great tackle. Iheanacho. Who receives the pass? He gives it to the. Oh, he can't put it in. Damn it, Sean. Wait, he gets it back. Hey, one stream look and he loses it again. He's tackled again before he can take a proper shot. Yeah. First one was probably more her crunch than the second. Unless Sean was able to have been, I don't know if Sean would have been able to pull off the worldie. But D-Walk Origi can put him in. And I don't know what ability he did young German has, but I know D-Walk Origi is clinical in front of it all. See, that's why, for most of the second team games, Origi wears the band. Because he is probably the most experienced name on that team. And you could argue he's probably the best player on the team. Definitely say he has the most goals. I mean, he was top goal scorer for one season.
Well, he's won it back. That's a really good tackle.
And he scored both goals so far in this match. So he's bagged himself a brace. He'll be looking for the hat trick.
Divock Origi.
Origi.
here comes the cross. That's a brilliant.
And Nacho can't get the ball properly. But he did win a corner, I will give him that. Ojo. Sean! He scored it! He does have a bit of a worldie in him. The young German hits it in superb fashion.
Well, in it goes via the underside of the bar. Always looks special.
Well, maybe a little bit of luck there, but he's hit it hard and true.
Came to him. I hit it in off the crossbar. Or they all count. Is live fly, and you can almost see the poor Ipswich fans behind the goal getting even sadder if they saw it was going in. Ojo! Ooh!
He's spotting it up now to take the corner. It's a headed effort at goal. And in with the goal.
Wait, I did get a fourth. It's Pullet. The big center defender from Belgium has his own say to his match. Towering header, probably the tallest guy in the box. Thing I don't know the heights of the Ipswich players, but none of them look that tall.
Now an extraordinary lead, and you could say really game over. Sometimes being a favourite in a match can wait.
I mean, Pollitt is out. I mean,
it's not a problem for this team, is it?
Even if you didn't know he was number 29, you
taken it easily.
He stands out. Look at
they've shown the class too.
Good take by the goalkeeper, but no pressure on him. Time for the opposition to spoil Liverpool's day, but they haven't looked like doing it because Liverpool haven't let them look like doing it. Maybe the cross. That's a useful ball in.
Riggy, we have one more chance to complete his hat trick. He's not really had a shot since he scored the second goal. They get it out of there. And Pittman clears and the final whistle goes. 4-0. Oh, no hat trick for Dave Okereke, but two goals and probably man of the match afterward as well. Boy, I'd be shocked if it went to anyone else. Well, it's not my team. Does she consider it? Yeah. Maybe you did? Oh, according to this, it went to Pullet, 9.9. Riggy did have a 9.8 game. Ojo played a 9.7 against the team he was on loan for. What? Pullet got a goal and an assist. Apparently a goal and assist is a point better than two goals. Huh, who knew? Ojo. Who also got an assist? The assists were very widely spread out, with Iturbe and Togging one in each as well. So both wingers, my side didn't admit, and one of my center backs. So in terms of the assist category, not the only Premier League team that won by four goals, Bournemouth were dominant in their match as well. And that may be Orban's last match for the club, because Southampton has said they will go ahead with signing him for the 5.5 million that I asked for. wants a new contract. He wants $100,000. He's not gonna accept squad rotation for $100,000. Sanchez and Platias both went up. Sanchez is now 73. Platias is now 67. Pullet and Formichao are both close to going up as well. Sean is like the odd man out. Holy shit! That's a lot of money. It's not enough, but holy shit. No. Did I get multiple transfer offers for the defending client? I think I did. I just... where's the, transfer negotiator? Like it was where Leverkusen, Fiorentina, where they are club interest in Tillemans. I got an 8 million offer for Royce. Is that in the left? Why don't I remember that? Maybe it was because of how angry I was at the end of the last episode. But even 8 million isn't enough. Providing these 11 pissed me off again. Because I can replace every single one of them and I still will win everything. It's not the players, it's my leadership that brings us glory. And these fuckers better remember that. So I want a dominating performance. And it's nothing against Watford. You're just the team in my way.
Up front with Neymar.
Passing the ball around will only get you so far. Or assholes. Because you have to go near my goal eventually. There we go. Now they're making progress.
So they'll be expecting to make it a double here.
Yeah, it was men against boys, wasn't it? I really can't see it being the same here, you know.
Jordan Ayew. Really strong play.
Thank you, America. I was thanking you too soon. You lost the ball almost immediately. In fact, you did lose it immediately. So I rescind that, thank you. I'm going to tell you that's one. You don't want to find out what happens if you get too many numbers. Tell me that's a red card, because he took Ronaldo off the ball. A yellow. And also, you know, I didn't see a lot of red cards from my opponents in this career mode. Yeah, I've had two teams get red cards against me in my final. And I need to remind this referee that that foul was off the ball, which is an automatic red card. Ronaldo didn't even have the ball when he fouled him. I guess he had the ball when he was going for the foul, but by the time the foul connected, Ronaldo had crossed the ball.
Just deflected behind for that.
So Tech plays off the ball and it's a red card offense. Timmons.
Well, they've got the free kick. Referee's
penalized. So I think he shoved someone as I bulldozed through with the defender. Coutinho! Oh! I took a deflection. I was unlucky.
Out of the danger zone.
I guess that makes me more unlucky than I was. I just thought I missed.
Are you?
Triguez can't keep it in. Great.
To restart it here.
See, it's another throwing. You know, they're only slightly getting closer to the goal. Which, you know, right now is not a problem. But if something were to come from them reversing, which didn't, thankfully. Not yet, anyway. Here they come again. Bernard. Great save. Fine. As I told him to make, I told him to pass it to Bale, he passed it to somebody else. I think he passed it to Ronaldo. Luckily I got a free kick out of it, so I guess I can forgive again not obeying what I told it to do.
Position back off, they could be in trouble, and the ball gets to here, and it's off the post.
Bale, that's one. That should have been a goal. How did you miss? You can score a batshit crazy free kick, but you can't score from about 5 yards out with the goal at your mercy. So yes, that is one. No one is safe. If you get enough numbers, you'll find out what happens. Because, like I said, everyone here is replaceable. And I include Ronaldo in that. I can replace him like that. He probably didn't hear me. He snapped my fingers.
With the naked eye, I don't think anyone could have been sure.
Keeper almost did the exact same thing that happened in the last episode against Norwich, which was really bizarre. Did not see that. That was crazy. The defender passed it back, and Ruddy kind of like hit it in for no particular reason.
So we're all set for the second half. Defender's worried now about Cristiano Ronaldo. Got past him.
Now look, get up.
Royce. He cleared that really well.
Do I just need to up your strengths, Royce? Because apparently you can't win a simple one-on-one! Coutinho! Thank you, Philip Coutinho! Oh. Go with what you know, and the only person... Him who put in any kind of effort to get a goal at this point. Everyone else seems to be allergic to the goal recently.
Here's a chance to move forward from midfield after that interception. cut off. Well, a corner to come because of that deflection. A decent fist away by the keeper.
Royce.
It's a corner again.
Good save.
Royce.
Royce again. There we go. Thank you, Marco. Oh. I still might have to up your strength, but it's good to see you're at least doing what you're here to do. And that is play to the best of your ability. I don't know where this was last episode, when you were all freaking useless, but hey. Hey. Sunrise, sunset.
Take over possession again.
Poor thing. Hits the ball. Fail. Still have it. Royce. Go. Rodriguez! Oh, unlucky! He gets the rebound! Oh, wait. Saying Coutinho scored. Coutinho is the one celebrating. Huh? Hey, what happened? Did it hit Coutinho?
Let's take another look at the goal.
Try and see. Oh yeah, it did hit him. Rodriguez robbed of a goal. Coutinho scores his second of the game. In his 10th of the season. Oh, that's... that's hilarious, but a bit depressing if you're Ricardo Rodriguez. And again, you worked your way into getting a goal. Well, but hey, you got involved in. Well, the game probably won't give you one. I'll say that's an assist. That's an assist in my book. The game won't give him one, but well, maybe it will. I don't know. I'll have to look at that. I'll have to check. I don't think it will. I'd be very surprised if it does an assist. An inadvertent assist. Whoa! Royce, he's away! He's so alone! It's 4-0! Two from Coutinho, two from Royce. Game over. Again, nothing against Watford. It just happens to be Watford. And this just happens to be how they should play in the last episode, but they didn't. Actually, this is how they should play in every game ever. But again, can't have everything.
We'll be delighted because they've not. That's a foul by Gareth Bale.
Really? Really? Wait.
The keeper might have been relieved there, Martin, because I don't think he would have got there. About Watford and their next game, Alan. Yeah, they're playing Newcastle United in their next match in the Barclays Premier League. Don't see them having too many problems. Coutinho.
There's the ball back line. Sends Neymar away, the keeper's gonna get there first. Wait. Hit it! Ah, I thought the keeper was off his line.
Here we can see it again. Marco.
It had been on target when he was saved it.
Neil.
He got back quick. Yeah, coming out.
Ricardo Rodriguez.
Rodriguez, great winning of the ball. Oh. Tillemans. Fouled? No? Really?
Two oohs around the crowd for a 3-minute add-on, which is what
we're going to do. Clear it. Thank you. Wait, full time whistle. Well, 4-0 is the final score. Looks like Coutinho got man of the match. Did it give Rodriguez an assist? It didn't. I thought it wouldn't. Because it was a shot and just happened to hit Coutinho. Oh. Oh. Bale got 2 assists. That's good enough for me to remove your number, Bale. So the only one who retains their number is Aimeric Laporte. Although, we didn't see any goals. Well, how did... What's his match rating? Is it higher? It's higher than Varane's. And it's higher than the keeper's. It's lower than Rodriguez's, but that's no real surprise. Rodriguez did have a very good game. Same as Ronaldo's. I guess if I don't take away his... Let's call him strikes. If I don't take it away... Yeah, I should technically give Varane one. Because he played worse. So... I will, Aimeric, but... This has to be a regular performance. Good performances. I don't... And anything like what happened in the last episode. And you can bet it when I play Crystal Palace again, and I will be absolutely ripping them to shreds. I'll have to look at that in my own time. Because that is the end of this episode. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Hit subscribe if you're new to the channel. Oh, and until next time. I hope you all have a very, very nice day.